Hey YouTube, my name is Dan and this is a short free extract of my longer course called Animated Infographics and Data Visualization. That course, along with the free exercise files for this particular video and a free downloadable cheat sheet, can be found at bringyourownlaptop.com. Hi there, in this tutorial we're going to make things all floppy and real like this using the puppet tool. Let's go and learn it. Okay, so we're going to do this in a separate comp. So up here, new composition, we're going to call this one puppet tool. Okay, everything's going to be the same. I'm going to use just an off gray. I don't know why. Cool. And we're going to bring in some files and I'm going to show you a different way of bringing them in. Here's my exercise files here, puppet one and two. We've been bringing them in kind of official ways. You can actually just drag them onto the page there. Okay, and you can see they've come through. I'm going to put them in my files. If you're on a PC, it works the same way. You just need to have the window open in front of it. Just drag it in. Off you go. Cool. So what I've got is puppet one. We're going to put them around this way. So puppet one is at the bottom. We're going to lock it because it's the cogs. We're not actually going to turn those. You could easily turn those into animated cogs. What we're going to do is our example where we get this to fly in and be all bendy. Zoom out a little bit so we can see everything. So first of all, we're going to add a little bit of animation. So on this, we're going to hit P for position and we're going to start the stopwatch and we'll start them over here. Okay. And after about, I don't know, that much. Okay. 10 frames, he's going to be maybe a little bit longer. Okay. 14 frames. I'm going to drag him in holding shift. So it goes perfectly straight. It's up to you. So you got to start dragging first and then hold shift. Cool. So we've got the first bits. And what we might do is we might add some easing. Now we've added easing to the beginning and end the whole the way through this. Okay, so what we're gonna do in this case is we're actually gonna just add easing to this last one because I wanted to start fast, okay, and slow down here at the end. Okay, so I'm gonna add velocity. I'm gonna get it to slow down to 75 because that's my favorite. So now it's gonna zoom along and then kind of slow down and stop there. If it doesn't, right click it again, go to keyframe velocity, and we're gonna change the speed here to zero. And now it should do it. Great. Awesome. So what we're gonna do is get that little tail thing to bend. Okay, so it's gonna zoom along, come down, stop, and we want it kind of bending out. To do it, we need to add some puppet points. Okay, and it's hard to do when it's off screen, so we're gonna move it so it's kind of halfway there. Grab the puppet tool, which is this guy there, looks like a draw pin. Okay, click on that. We need three in this case. We need one there, one about middle, and about one at the end. You can have as many as you want, depending on how much control you want over it. The less pins, the easier it is and more natural it looks. Now, these are actually adding keyframes at the same time. So if I click on the puppet 2 and hit U, maybe my secret shortcut, showing me all the keyframes. If I move this other way, there's all the keyframes that have been made. I kind of made them at the wrong stage. Okay, I want them to be all the way over here at the beginning. Cool. It's just easier to do, obviously, when it's on screen than it's off screen. Cool. So first up, I want to grab this guy. Still got my puppet tool. Gonna grab this one and kind of drag, undo. I've got them all selected down here, so I'm gonna click off. I'm gonna grab this guy. Okay, I'm gonna grab this guy. And then if you slide along, that's kind of what's happening. Okay, he's kind of like zooming across. So let's hit spacebar. So now what we need to do is when it gets close to this end part here, we need to just move the keyframes around. So I'm gonna grab this one, straighten it back up. To be honest, I probably should have left one more keyframe in the head there to stop it bending, but hey ho. Okay, we're getting there. You can see it's not doing the little flippity flop that I want. Okay, so I'm going to line it back up here. And actually what I wanted to do is go a little bit past where I wanted it. Okay, so it's going to go like that. Then after a couple more frames, it's going to kind of flop back. Here we go. Floppity flop. Not too far. And then another couple of frames. We're going to get it go just a bit back further again. We're getting close to its kind of final rest. There we go there. Now the timing is all going to be a bit mixed up when you first do it. Okay, so we're going to have to play around with it. So let's not get too excited. Ready? Let's click off. And space. It's not our best, but you get the idea, right? That's what we're going to do. So what do I need it to do? We're going to have to play around with the timing of these. So I'm going to select them all, hold down Alt, and just drag them out. Does it feel like it needs more? Or does it need less? I'm holding Alt and it kind of compresses them while I'm dragging them. That might be it. So, yep. Cool. Yep. It's getting there. Maybe just these three out. Now I'm just playing around with timing, and this will happen to all your projects. Okay, you'll spend ages with this kind of like last part where you're just finessing it. Okay, there's no exact rules because it depends on the shape of the object, how fast it's moving, and what you kind of want it to feel like. Yeah, it's getting there. I think probably I need to bring this whole thing across because it's taking too long to slide across. Maybe too far. Okay, it's a little bit painful to watch, I know. Okay, maybe that's what I need. It needs to be longer. Just tapping a bit too fast. Yeah, I'm liking it. Okay, now I'm just wiggling around and playing. I guess I could edit it and make it perfect on the first time, and you'd be doing it going, mine doesn't look that good. Okay, and so I'm doing it for you, my people. Okay, there's a lot of playing around with this type of stuff, especially with Puppet Tool, because you're kind of faking real life. Okay, and there's a lot of wiggling around. Okay, it's quite cool if you get like, say it's a glass of water and it's flopping in, you can get the water to kind of flop back and forth as you'd imagine it would. If you've got a person, say this little icon here, it's kind of popping, sliding in, her hair could kind of like bend as she comes in. All right, and that is going to be it for the Puppet Tool. Let's get on to the next tutorial. Hey there, what'd you think? If you like the video, hit the like button, that'd be great. Also consider subscribing to my channel. Now, this is a free part of a longer course. You can check that out on bringyourownlaptop.com. On that site is a free downloadable, printable PDF cheat sheet, okay, to help you with your infographics and data visualization. Also on that site is a bunch of other courses as well. So go check it out, bringyourownlaptop.com. Bye now.